special His presence. Just send your glory, Kyle. Can I work on the Lord unless I have your glory? Let him meet you face to face this morning. Let him meet you face to face this morning. Have your experience. Don't leave the church and you haven't had your experience with the presence of the Lord. You should have just stayed home. If you don't want to experience in His presence, experience the presence of the Lord in the house this morning. Experience His presence. Meet Him face to face. Experience His presence. Young people, press in. Press in, young people. Don't just come to church because your mama or your father brought you, but press in while you're here. Get something from the Lord while you're here. You get something from Him so He can give you something to give back out. very familiar passage of scripture. You can get your Bibles out. You don't have to. It doesn't matter. I can read it in English. Just want to go over just a little bit. 22 and down to verse 33. Our bishop sings this song all the time. Here is Jesus. Just got word that John the Baptist had been killed. The prophet that baptized him and sent him his ministry is dead. Starts off in the from the first verse on down, chapter 14. When he got word, the Bible says that John's disciples came to him and he got in the boat. I can only imagine how he felt. Hearing the news that the person who was the forerunner, you can be seated, that was the forerunner of his ministry is now dead. So he got in the boat to go to a solitary place. Gets there. The multitude begin to hear of Jesus being in the city. So they came. Jesus being who he is, he began to do what he does best, to minister to the people. The Bible says that he began to heal the sick, and then as he was healing the sick, the disciples said they had been with them all day. The disciples said, Lord, they've been with us all day. They need to go home and eat. Jesus said, No. I got two fish and five loaves. I'm going to feed the 5,000 plus the women and children. So he does this miracle. Now remember, Jesus still has not had time to grieve for John. So he says, okay, now he sends the crowd away and then he tells the disciples, you go ahead on and get in the boat and go on ahead. I'm going to go pray. Our bishop said, we ask questions of the text. So I asked the question of the text. What did Jesus have to pray about? He knew his destiny. He knew why he was there. But can I say this to you? It's not proven. But I believe that when he got wind of what had happened to John, that his ministry really did get real for him.
So they sit in the boat
walking on water. And immediately they got afraid. Now, the question that I ask myself is, this is the same Jesus in Matthew chapter number 8, that when the winds and the storms came, he calmed the winds and the storm. What was it that they did not recognize? The same God who had power to tell the nature to cease. When the what is going on around you, it causes you to lose focus on the who, and it is still Jesus. They were in a storm. They had seen him all day. The what was happening around them. So it was, they didn't recognize but Peter. Remember, it was Peter who, when the storm came before, went to the bottom of the boat and spoke to Jesus. It was Peter who was the one. So Peter, I believe that Peter remembered, wait a minute, hold on. This has happened before.
Come on.
Lord, if this is you, tell me to come. Let me not say something to you. Peter asked the Lord a question, and the Lord gave him an answer. And the storm was still going on. Peter did not focus on the light. When he asked of the Lord spoke back. Can I tell you something? When you are in the middle of your storm, ask the Lord, and he will speak back. When the word spoke back to Peter, something happened. Romans 12, around verse number 3, Paul tells us, start getting over to the different giftings. But before he gets into that, he said that God has given every man a measure of faith. The same measure that got Peter out the boat can't be the same measure that caused him to walk. Let me say it again. The same measure of faith that you was even operating in on last week cannot be the same measure of faith that you need to operate in on this week. There's a measure of faith that God wants to stretch us and add us and add to us that will cause us to move. When the word spoke, Peter moved. He moved. His faith jumped. He gets out the boat. Tracy, now remember, the storm is still going on. The storm has not ceased. The what around him was still happening. But his focus was on Jesus. This is the miraculous part. Not only did Jesus walk on water, but Peter did too. Can I say something to you? Can I say something to you? When our focus is on the Lord and it's still Jesus, when we are focused on him, regardless of what is happening, God will cause us to do some things we've never done before. Y'all not hear me today? There's a measure of faith that God wants for us to do that we've never done before. There's some things that God wants us to birth that we've never birthed before. There's a belief in us that God wants us to have that we've never had before. No, build me up. What's up?
when he gives us, God will never give us the complete. He'll never give it to us complete. All he'll give us is the raw material. It's up to us to create. He'll give you a thought. He'll give you a vision. He'll give you a dream. He'll say something to you. And it's up to us to create it. He never gave you a chair. He just gave us one. He's working on water, Latisha. He's doing something he has never done before. And the water and the storm is still there. It's not that what's happening in our life is not relevant. It's not that the stuff that we go through is not real. The difference is whether or not we are focusing on what we have, what we don't want, what we don't have, what we need, what this, what that. It's a matter if we are focusing more on the what and less on the who. Yes. The storm was yet there. Peter began to walk. He was walking on water, doing something he has never done before. Now the house, this is new for Peter. There's some stuff, prophet, it's just new for us. It's just, let me tell you something. I don't even like politics. But I know the Lord told me to take the government. Doing something that I've never done before. I can't focus on what I'm seeing. I gotta focus on who called me to come out the boat. And then walk on the water with me. There are things you're not gonna have the experience. Come on! There's some stuff.
Experience all the whole time he was in.
But then there are seasons in our life that the God of Matthew 14 will just be there with you during the storm. Yes. He will always come for you. Yes.
Come on.
But when you're walking in the storm, yes, with him,
come on.
When you're walking in the storm, with everything that's going around and your focus is on him, baby, you can walk on water. Spaces, sister, and we out there. just saying. The other disciples stayed in that boat, Connie. I ain't about to go out there. I can roll this bad boy back to shore. This is my comfort zone. This I know how to work. There's some stuff that we know how to work. There's some stuff that I get can work well for us. There's some stuff that we are just anointed to do. But God is trying to stretch our faith.
Yes,
that's good. That your mojo won't work for you out in this world. You don't have a safety guard. All you have is Jesus. The disciple was like, hold on. We can roll this bad boy back. We can do this. It was enough of them. We can We can get this bad boy back to the shore. But we already out here in the middle of nowhere and it's dark. Can't see. He's trying to get us out of a place that we can navigate.